Hello YouTube! In this video I want to show you how a proper and efficient cut works. Today it's almost 40 degrees in Switzerland. That's why I'm sitting here at the creek so I can cool down my legs and my feet a little bit. So many people who only press the knife in one direction if they want to make a cut, this in one direction, but pressing the knife in one direction is more splitting than cutting, and splitting is not really efficient. Look at this. This is a movement in one direction. But that the knife works, you need to cut. You need a sideways movement. And if I make the same, with the same pressure and the same speed, like this, I would have a terrible cut in my finger. And like this, nothing happened. This is the same by carving in wood. If you only press like this, you are not efficient. An efficient cut works like this. Hold your knife in the fist grip. It is important that you have about a 90 degree angle between your arm and your blade. And when you start with the cut, very close by your hand, the tip looks a little bit backwards, not forward, backwards. And then you make a movement like a windshield wiper, like this. You have to oil it. I show you in slow motion. So now I press the knife forward and at the same time I have a sideways movement from the handle to the tip. And this is how an efficient cut works. I show you now what physically happens when you have a sideways movement in your cut. This is the wood you want to cut. And this is your blade. If you only press the knife into the wood, you dive about in a 90 degree angle into the wood. And the penetration angle is the same angle as your cutting edge angle. But if you push and pull, you dive diagonal into the wood. And this affects that you have a much more smaller penetration angle. And this is the secret, because the push and pull technique is much more easier than only push. Now I show you how it really works while carving. The whole movement is very dynamic. That means the sideways movement is like a little explosion, like tack, 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 tack. And because of the fast sideways movement, I have such a small penetration angle that the blade penetrates really easy. If you want to cut away the side branch, don't only push like a gorilla. It's the same. As more sideways movement you have, as easier the blade or the edge penetrate into the wood. So make sure that you have enough space here, and then pack. Again, pack. Again, pack. If you are interested to learn more about the Swiss Army knife, please have a look at my playlist. So that's it for today. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you next time.
All right.